What's up?
Happy New Year!
Hey, everyone.
Jerry, it is a whole brand new year, and I'm so excited to welcome our brand new VIPs.
Hi, VIPs.
Jerry, do you want to go ahead and tell them what a VIP is?
Yeah, you're a VIP if it's your first time here. So, like, I really want to just give you, like, a big special welcome and invite you to our program. And Liz, I'm sure I'm missing something, right?
Yeah, probably, because we also have a very special prize for you.
What?
And some instructions at the end. I know. I'm so excited. So you want to stick around because there's a lot of new things going on, right? New year. We've got a new theme. We're going to be learning some new Bible stories, some new things that we need to learn about God. You know, all the good stuff.
Whoa. Are we learning about God this month?
Yes, we are. Absolutely, we are.
Didn't we learn about God last month?
Yes, we learn about God every month. But we're gonna We're going to learn new things that we didn't know about him before.
Cool. So there's a lot to learn, I'm sure.
Yes, there absolutely is a lot to learn. And one thing that we're learning today is about responsibility.
Uh-oh.
I know. What do you mean, uh-oh?
Not good for me.
What?
I'm just saying I have a lot to learn.
Okay, well, it's okay. It's a safe space. We're going to learn together.
Cool.
Yeah, it's going to be fine. And Jerry, do you want to introduce our cool theme for this month?
Yes, our theme for this month is called Pet Project because pets, you know, take a lot of responsibility and stuff too. Also, I'd like to address the giraffe in the room for a moment because apparently when you go out, people consider me to be your pet. Is this true or is this false?
Yes, Jerry. People do ask all the time when I go in and visit campuses and stuff if you're my pet. And I mean, I don't, you know.
Tell them no, right?
Yeah, I tell them no. I tell them no because just so everyone knows, Jerry is not my pet.
Thank you for clarifying.
But he is a giraffe and he hangs around me.
I am a pet. I am not her pet.
Whose pet are you?
God's.
No, that's not how that works.
It is how it works.
Okay, all right.
I've read the Bible.
Okay, all right, fine. Here's the thing. Every name is very, very extremely important. For example, did you know that God has a lot of different names? It's so cool.
I didn't know that.
I know, because each name tells us something about who he is. It tells us a portion of his character and how much he loves us. Isn't that cool?
Oh, it's very, 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 very cool.
So that's something that we're going to be learning.
I want to learn more about this.
I know, me too. I'm really excited to learn about it. So each month this year, we'll learn a little bit about one of God's names. It's going to be super, super cool. Okay. Well, it's a good thing that we're talking about loving God and loving others this week.
Actually, speaking of loving others, I actually think we do our shout out for the week. You ready for this?
Let's do it.
Okay. Our shout out for this week is for Sean from Richmond, Virginia.
What's up, Sean? Hey.
Hey, buddy. So that actually leads us to our Liz quiz for the month. And I've got a very bad idea for the Liz quiz. It's unlike anything we've ever done before. Are you ready?
What? I'm nervous now.
Yeah, that's the point. So you're going to be blindfolded and then we're going to bring in a couple different pets. And you actually have to like put your hands on the pet if you get the question wrong. But we're not going to tell you what the pet is, obviously.
Wait, like the mystery box thing and I have to figure out what pet it is?
Yes, it's a mystery box, but inside is something living.
Okay. Oh, okay. Well, I mean, if it's a cute, like, little bunny rabbit, like, that would be really fun.
Spoiler alert, it's not.
No. Okay, well, I'm a little bit nervous now, but what happens if I get it right?
Okay, I'll tell you what. If you get a couple of these right this month, we will actually get a new pet for our set. Okay, all right, here we go. Virginia was the first U.S. state to grow these. Was it A, peanuts?
Peanuts, oh, interesting, okay.
Yes. Was it B, grapes?
Grapes? I don't know.
Yeah, okay. All right. Was it C, potatoes?
Potatoes?
Mashed potatoes.
Potatoes? I like potatoes.
Or was it D, green beans?
What? Okay, so the first state, that means that none of these things are natural to other states. How did I not know that? It's crazy. Okay.
I don't know if that's true or not.
Maybe, because if it's the first state to grow them, then, like, other states wouldn't have ever had them before.
How's your agricultural knowledge?
Not very good. Not very good. Okay.
They didn't teach you that in Bible college, did they?
No, they didn't. It's fine. Okay. I'm going to guess, is it potatoes? No.
No. Sorry.
Oh, no.
Sorry. Boo.
I'm so sorry.
The answer was peanuts.
Oh, okay. so I'm so nervous. So I have to like do the challenge, not knowing what I'm gonna be trying to touch. Oh wow, okay, I'm very, very nervous, but I think it'll be fine. If it's, you know, if it's like a little, maybe a little kitty cat, it's so cute.
It's not, just so you know. Kids, stick around because we're gonna find out what this animal is today. It's gonna be great.
All right, everybody. Well, let's go ahead and we're just gonna move past that. We'll get to that later, but let's go ahead and get ready to worship. We're going to be learning about loving God and loving others today, remember? So it's a great time to show God how much we love him. Let's go ahead and stand to our feet and get ready.
Dancing through the trial to the rhythm of your heartbeat, heartbeat.
You guys can go ahead and have a seat. Today, we're learning to love God and love others. We'll see how doing those two things will help us do all the things God wants us to do. Let's check in with Story Lab so they can explain.
Which one?
Orange.
Story Lab. This week we're talking about responsibility, while we take a look at the most important thing of all time. If you were a fish, which one of these would you choose? Anyway, that's not the most important thing of all time.
Hey, I'm Carter.
And I'm Zeke.
We're talking about responsibility,
which is showing you can be trusted with what is expected of you.
I expect you're gonna tell me what these are about?
Aquarium plants.
Wait, you got a fish?
I got a fish.
For Christmas?
Christmas will live on all year in my new ichthyoid friend.
Ichthyoid means fish-like.
Fish are super easy to take care of, right? I mean, aquarium, fish food, done.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
So it's not that simple?
Let's just say that taking care of a fish looks a bit more like this.
I can't even... You need all of this for one tiny fish?
One tiny fish, aka Finn.
Finn? Meet Carter. Carter? Finn.
Finn, huh?
Yeah, pretty good, right?
Nah, but I see what you did there. What does all this stuff do?
Well, the water conditioner removes metals and chlorine from the water. And betas are tropical fish, so this guy needs a heater to keep the water warm. And of course, you've got to check the water temperature.
Isn't that a meat thermometer?
It works really well. But Mom did use this to check some baked salmon the other day, so...
That does not seem right.
Finn is a super picky eater, so I give him bloodworms as a treat.
But he is super cute. Aquarium test strips?
Okay, see, this is the complicated part.
It wasn't complicated already?
When you first set up an aquarium, it has to cycle.
That cannot mean what I'm thinking.
The tank has to establish a nitrogen cycle. See, fish waste and extra food decompose, creating ammonia. Ammonia is poisonous to fish, but over time, good bacteria grow inside your aquarium. They break down the ammonia into nitrite and nitrate, which still aren't great for your fish. But when algae grows in your tank, it eats the nitrate as food.
So, how long does it take for this whole nitrogen cycle thing to work?
2 months.
2 months? How's Finn going to make it?
Well, I gotta test for nitrogen and ammonia every day and do lots of water changes.
That sounds like a lot of work.
Finn is totally worth it, I think.
Well, I certainly hope little fish face here feels the love.
Speaking of love, it's time for...
The Story Before the Story.
Today, we're in the book of Matthew.
Matthew is one of four books called the Gospels. These books tell stories from the life of Jesus.
Matthew was written down by, you guessed it, Matthew, one of Jesus' followers, a tax collector whose life was turned upside down by his friendship with Jesus.
When Jesus was about 30 years old, he began to travel from town to town, teaching and healing. Everywhere Jesus went, big crowds gathered. Some people were desperate to be made well. Others came to hear his teaching.
But the religious leaders were troubled by Jesus and feared that he would change things.
So some of the leaders tried to trap Jesus. They asked him trick questions, hoping to prove him wrong or stir up the crowds. But Jesus always knew the wise way to respond.
Which is where our story starts.
Hey, hey everyone, I'm Brian. So, the religious leaders had become more and more worried about Jesus and his teaching. When Jesus entered Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover festival, great crowds welcomed him as a king. So, those religious leaders began making plans to arrest him and amped up their attempts to trick him.
Who told you to do all these things?
Yeah, what gives you the right?
In every case, Jesus avoided their traps and gave wise answers. When one group of leaders failed to catch Jesus in his own words, another group, the Pharisees, decided to give it a try. One of their best law experts stepped up to test Jesus.
Teacher, which is the most important commandment in the law?
Whichever rule Jesus picks as the most important, he'll have to leave out the other 612 laws.
Then we can get everyone mad at him for choosing the wrong one.
Yes.
I love it when a plan comes together.
But Jesus just answered wisely once again.
Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your mind. This is the first and most important commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. Everything that is written in the law and the prophets is based on these two commandments.
Okay, you see the amazing thing Jesus did there? He said that when you show love to God and show love to people, you will also be following all the other laws. If you love God and love others, you'll grow in telling the truth, in obeying your parents, in treating others well. Jesus didn't leave anything out. He included every single law in those first two. Love God, love others. It's that simple. But that doesn't mean it's easy all the time. See, God doesn't want us to just check off a list of rules every day.
Hey, what do I do now?
When we follow Jesus, God sends the Holy Spirit to be with us and guide us. Over time, we can learn to listen and discover fresh ways each day to love God and love others. There are unlimited ways we can do that. But here's a place to start. You can show love to God by spending time with God. You can read God's word in the Bible and tell God about all the great things and all the hard things in your life. One of the most amazing ways we can show love to God is actually by showing love to others, people made in God's very own image. You can show love to others by sharing what you have. And this might be your stuff, but it could also be your time, your listening ear, or your ideas and your creativity. You can show love by working hard to help others, your parents, siblings, friends, teacher, anybody you see who needs your help. You can also show love by using your words wisely to encourage others. Let's take a look at Jesus' words one more time. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your mind. This is the first and most important commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. Everything that is written in the law and the prophets is based on these two commandments. Just as Jesus said, when we focus on those two commandments, we can know that we are following all of God's laws. The end.
Wow, Jesus made it so simple,
but so not easy.
Exactly. Being in right relationship with God isn't about a bunch of rules.
So, what's our part in the story?
We're designed to need God, moment by moment, so we can discover what it looks like to love God and love others. There are several awesome ways to show love to God. The first is giving God your time.
You can read God's words recorded in the Bible.
And you can tell God anything that's on your heart or mind.
You can even sing to God.
Yeah, that's right. Another awesome way to show love to God is to love others. And this is where you have to really pay attention because everybody's different.
We all enjoy gifts, but some people feel extra loved if you make them a card or bake them cookies.
Some people feel loved when you hang out with them and spend time doing their favorite stuff.
For reals, my dad likes to fish, which is not my thing, but I do it anyway because I know it's super important to him.
There's some people who feel most loved with a high five or a hug.
And some people most need you to encourage them and say something you appreciate about them.
There are also people who really feel loved when you do something for them.
Like when you unload the dishwasher when it's your brother's turn.
Or make sandwiches for dinner so your mom or dad don't have to cook.
Just use your imagination. There's always some way that you can show love to God and to others. See you next time.
So, here's the thing. Love God and love others.
And love the creatures God made.
Can we feed him again?
No way, no how.
But it was really fun to watch him slurp those worms up like spaghetti.
Never overfeed a fish. But we can entertain him.
Oh.
With my new beta playlist.
Look, he's dancing, he's grooving, look. Go fish, go fish. Oh, that's right. Oh. Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab.
See you next time.
Go fish. Look, he's moving his fin. Is it fin? It fins?
Yeah.
See?
You just got it?
That's right. That's why you... Okay. Now I see. Gotcha.
Wow. Jesus himself encouraged us to love God and love others because he knew doing those two things would help us follow everything God has asked us to do. So let's talk about what we've learned. Alika is going to help us do just that because it's group time.
Hey friends, what's up? It's Alika and I have my son,
AB.
And it is group talk. Group talk. Every... What's up, you guys? I'm so excited to be talking with you guys specifically this month on loving God and loving others, right?
Yeah.
This week is going to be super cool because loving God, can you say love God?
Love God.
And love others?
Love others.
Love God?
Love God.
Love others?
Love.
What about you guys? Say it with me. Say love God.
Love God.
Love others?
Love others.
It is so important to know how we can love God and love others. But before we do that, AB, I think it's important. We need to go through our memory verse. You ready to do that?
Yeah.
All right, real quick. If you guys have your Bibles, go ahead and pull that out. But AB, can you open up the Bible really quickly? And let's pull up Luke chapter 16, verse 10. You ready?
Okay, so whatever can be trusted with very little can be also with much.
Awesome. It says, whoever can be trusted with very little can also be trusted with much. All right, so let's do something really cool with that. Say, whoever can be trusted.
Whoever can be trusted.
With very little.
With very little.
Can also be trusted.
Can we also be trusted.
With very much.
Very much.
Luke chapter 16, verse 10.
Luke chapter 16, verse 10.
Oh my gosh. Good job, you guys. Okay, now, loving God and loving others. AB, okay, so talk to me. What's the first thing that comes to mind when we say, when Daddy says, love God and love others, what comes to your brain?
Love others and love God.
Wow, that's the same thing I just said. What do you feel like loving God means? How do you love God?
God?
Yeah.
Because Jesus was risen.
Okay, that is very, very true. But how do you love God? What do you do to tell God that you love him?
What do I do to
tell God that you love me?
To tell God do I love him?
Yeah.
Like pray.
Yeah.
And read the Bible.
That's great. Ooh, this is a cool question. When do you pray?
When do we pray? Every day!
Every day? Okay. Like, what times during the day? Like, do we pray in the morning, the night?
In the morning, afternoon, and the night.
And the night. Like, what about, like, dinner time?
Yeah.
Yeah, typically you pray during dinner.
And breakfast.
And breakfast?
Lunch.
What? I don't know what you're saying right now. Okay.
I said lunch.
Okay. All right. So really quick, and you guys, and I want you guys to think about that, friends. Like, how do you feel? What do you think when I say love God and love others? Okay. So let's jump into a really fun question. Okay.
Okay.
AB, if you could have any pet in the world, what pet would you have?
I would have you know what I would have?
What?
You know what's the worst pet in the world?
No, what pet would you have if you could have any pet?
I just have an English bulldog.
Ooh!
And then you know what's the worst one in the world?
What's
cats.
The worst? Oh, cats! Why would you want an English bulldog?
Because they're so cute.
Cute. Okay. I think they're kind of funny too, right?
Yeah, they're also funny.
They're super funny. But we kind of have like an allergy situation.
I don't. I can touch dogs.
Okay, fine. Me.
But not cats.
Okay, fine. Me. Okay. Well, let's go back to our discussion and questions. You ready? So, how do you love your sister?
By giving her presents.
By giving her presents? Okay. That's one way. Has Abella ever gotten you a present?
No. Yes.
Yes? Okay. What about, when have you felt a time that mommy loved you? Well, so, I love it. And this is how, you know, loving God and loving others is really super simple. And it's so important to really just practice it each and every single day, right? And I think that's what we can tell our friends that are watching right now, is how can they love God and love others. Cool?
Yeah, cool.
Okay, let's pray. Let's pray. Jesus, we love you. We thank you. Thank you, God, for teaching us how to love others and teaching us what's most important is loving you, God. God, we ask that you continue to show us how we can love others and love you more and more each and every single day. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, everyone. I hope you're ready for an awesome memory verse because this month's verse is so good. It's Luke 16:10, and it says, "Suppose you can be trusted with something very little, that you can also be trusted with something very large." When you open up your Bible, you'll find the table of contents near the beginning. This will tell us which page number Luke starts on. In my Bible, the book of Luke begins on page 1961, so 1961. Now I need to find chapter 16. The big numbers are the chapters and the little tiny numbers are the verses. So I'm gonna find the big number 16. Here it is. Now I'll look for the small number 10. I found it. Our memory verse is Luke 16:10a. And if you've been looking and paying attention really closely, you'll notice the A. The A just means it's the beginning of the verse that we are memorizing this month. It says, "Suppose you can be trusted with something very little, then you can also be trusted with something very large." Remember to put a sticky note on this page or use your Bible's bookmark so you can continue to learn our memory verse. I'll see you next week for another memory verse challenge. Bye.
Okay, guys, I have had so much fun today. And now it's time to have even more fun because guess what time it is? It's game time.
What's up, everybody? My name is David, and this is my dog, Rolly. Isn't he so cute? And let me tell you why we're gonna win, because not only is he cute, but he's super smart.
Hey, guys, I'm Steven. This is Bernie. And we're probably not gonna win because I'm not 100% sure she speaks English yet.
My name is Jacob. This is my dog, Millie. And Millie, hey, there you go. And we're gonna win today's competition because my dog is obedient.
What?
Yo, my name is Peyton. This is my puppy, Harley. We're gonna win because I have the best trained dog, as you can tell. Look how sweet she is. Can't beat it. Let's go. Harley? Hey, hey, me, hey. As you can
sit. Good boy, lie down. Hey, lie down. Good boy, roll over. Roll over. Good boy, get up.
Step one, shake. Two, spin around. Spin around, spin around.
Sit.
Good girl. Oh, thank you. Here you go.
Okay, sit. Good girl, Millie. You're so good. Look how obedient she is.
Alrighty, as you can tell, my dog is obviously the better of the two. She's trained, she can do tricks. She's, you know, decent at protecting, which still working on that aspect of it. Her agility is top tier, you can't beat her. She's like a rabbit. So anyways, vote for Harley. Tell him you want to be voted for. Go, say something, what do you want to say? No, absolutely nothing.
Okay, everyone, if you thought that Rolly and I were the best, I want you to yell his name. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Rolly, 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 Rolly.
If you think Bernie is the cutest, sweetest puppy and she's gonna win these games, I need you to chant, Bernie, 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 Bernie.
All right, everybody. If you think that Millie and I are the best dog combo, I need you to chant for me, okay? Ready? 3, 2, 1. Millie, 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 Millie. Good girl, Millie!
Thanks for being here with me today, everybody. I had so much fun learning that we can love God and love others. And if it's your first time watching today, make sure you tell a grown-up in your house that there's a link below this video just for them. They'll be able to fill out some information to send back to us so we can reach out to you and say hi. Now, let's go ahead and pray. So let's go ahead and bow our heads, close our eyes, and we're gonna talk to God. Jesus, we love you so much. Thank you for helping us know that we can love God and love others. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen. Great job, everybody. We had so much fun together today. And now, you guys know what time it is. It's time for the Liz Quiz Challenge. Oh, here we go.
All right, Liz, here we go. You ready for our mystery pet for the day?
I don't know. I'm kind of nervous, but, you know, Jerry, I trust you, so it should be fine.
You still trust me?
No, I really don't.
Okay.
I shouldn't, but, you know.
All right, here we go. Right. Bring in the mystery pet.
Okay, I'm nervous. I'm going to guess it's probably going to be, like, a little puppy or maybe, like a precious little bird. What do you think? Like, something like that?
Oh, yeah. Go ahead, reach out and just grab the little bird.
I'm just gonna be like delicate because, oh, hold on. Oh, wait a second. This feels cold. This feels scaly.
Correct.
Feeling very, not slimy, but definitely cold. It feels scaly. Hang on, wait, hang on. Jerry?
Yeah?
Jerry. This is a live animal, correct?
This is a very live animal.
This is a live animal, okay.
Yes.
Is it like dangerous?
It is not dangerous, specifically probably because you know it.
I know it?
Wait, yes.
Hang on, I'm kinda nervous. Jerry, is this a snake?
It is.
What?
She's going wild,
Jerry,
right now.
This is my pet. This is Petunia. Okay, guys, this could have been really scary, but this is my pet. This is Petunia, and she's pretty chill, pretty calm. Jerry, what were you thinking? This is crazy.
I'm sorry I stole your pet Copperhead.
No, it's not Copperhead. No,
what is it?
She's a ball python.
Oh, very different.
Very different. Yeah, she is non-venomous. She's safe. She's fine. What on earth? Okay, wait. So here's the thing. If I get it right next time, that means that I get a point, and, right? Like, what happens?
Yeah. So if you get it right next time, you'll get a point, and then after 3 points, we'll get a pet for, you know, our little setback here.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and start thinking about what kind of pets that I hope that we get. Maybe like a parrot? What do you think?
I hate birds.
Okay.
Birds are natural predators of giraffe.
No, I don't think so. I don't think that's right.
Okay. Tell that to my cousin Tom.
Okay, what? All right, that seems like a story for another day. So we're just gonna go ahead and say bye, everybody. Thanks so much for joining us, and make sure you catch us next week to see what else happens.
Bye, everyone. Bye, Petunia.
Bye, Petunia.
Who's my good boy? Who's my good boy? Do you want a belly rub? Do you want a belly rub? Ooh, does that feel good? You want a treat? Who wants a treat?
Oh, did you get a new pet?
I did. It's right here.
Oh, let me see him.
No, no, wait. Shh. He's really shy around new people. Can you just, you know, stay still?
Oh, like this?
Perfect. Okay, here we go. John,
I would like you to meet Dwayne.
That's a rock.
I know, but it's a pet rock. His name is Dwayne.
A rock cannot be a pet.
Yeah, Dwayne is so a pet.
No, he's not.
He is a pet. He's
no,
too. Yeah,
no, what does he is. Do, then?
He's a pet. What does he do? Okay, you ready? Here we go. Fetch. Go get it. I'll get it. Come on, Dwayne. Stay. Here you go, boy. Okay, roll over. Roll up. Here we go. Wee. Wee. Yeah. Come on, boy. Sit up. Sit up. Come on, boy. Up. Sit up. Sit. Up. Come on. Come on. Come on. Okay, you know what? Dwayne's not a pet.
Good. Let's go get your real pet.
Great.
It doesn't matter. Dwayne is the most electrifying rock in show business.
Welcome to the So-and-So Show. I'm Brandon.
I'm John, and we're kicking off a discussion all about responsibility.
Yeah, one of us had a brilliant idea.
It was me.
To get a studio pet, because one of the best ways you can show you're responsible is by taking care of another creature.
Yes, my mother has let me know many o times that I can't even take care of myself. So this is my chance to prove I am responsible.
The pet can be as simple as a snail.
Or as demanding as a dolphin.
I like it.
The question is, how do we find out which pet is right for our studio?
And the answer,
pet auditions.
All right, let's see who we have first.
Okay. First up, we have Holly. She's 3 years old. She's 27 inches tall and 5.7 pounds. And she's a chicken. Her special skills are laying eggs, doing the chicken dance, and doing the two-wing cha-cha.
You know, chickens are in right now, especially with the price of eggs.
Yes. Okay, well, it says here that Holly is used to a 15 by 15 square foot living space and needs at least four or three other hens to keep her company.
15 by 15 feet? That's bigger than my bedroom.
Yeah, and I don't know if I want to get four pets, so maybe we should, you know, pass on Holly.
Okay, you tell her. Well,
I'm not going to tell her, you tell her.
Fine. Thank you, Holly. We'll let you know. Thank you.
Okay, smooth. Who's next?
All right, let's see. We have 2-year-old Larry. He's 5'7" and he weighs 320 pounds.
Woo!
He's friendly, mild-mannered, and clean. Maybe you can learn a thing or two from him.
Hey.
Let's see. But he does have a tendency for spinning, kicking, and neck wrestling.
Neck wrestling.
That's what it says, right? Neck wrestling.
And chew very loudly.
It's not good for sound.
No, it's not.
You tell him.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Larry. Thanks. You're a great llama. But hey, we'll let you know. Okay.
Get another one.
Okay. Oh. We have Sebastian. He's over 3 feet tall and weighs 423 pounds, and he's a tiger. No way.
Now this. Is the perfect pet.
Yeah, it says he's housebroken and he loves belly rubs, huh?
Oh, he's a cute little tiger.
Oh.
Yes, he is. Yes.
Oh! We'll let you know.
It's Bible story time.
Getting a pet, huh?
Yes.
Maybe. Yes.
Maybe. Just not a scary tiger.
Well, getting a pet is a big responsibility. But as followers of Jesus, we have an even bigger responsibility. Want to know what it is?
Do llamas make loud chewing noises?
I'm gonna say yes.
Then take it away.
Today's Bible story comes from the book of Matthew. Matthew wrote about a time when a religious leader was trying to test Jesus by asking him a question. And Jesus' answer to that question tells us a lot about what God expects us to do.
Da-da-da-da-da-da!
Oh!
Time for Bible-sizing with Horvath!
Oh, that must be...
Whoa! Horvaths!
Hello, Horvath.
Ah.
Wanna help me tell the story today?
Yes, I do! Thank you so much for having me on your shows! I am Horvath, and I am an expert in combining the mental trainings of learning the Bible with the physical trainings of making your muscles bigger!
The way this works is I'll tell the story, and Horvath will give us some exercises to help us remember it.
Yay! Okay, you say the Bible stories, I do exercise. All right, let's do this!
Wonderful. Okay, so the religious leader came up to test Jesus, maybe even trick him. When he asked Jesus this question, which is the most important commandment in the law?
Stop! First exercise! Okay, I call this curling the law. And we need some special equipment for this exercise. We will be using the Understandings Corporate Law textbooks.
Oh.
Haha, you first raise this giant book straight out in front of you. Before curling it back, oh, working on those biceps. Then you straighten it back out. Why are you not exercising?
Oh, I was watching.
No watching exercise.
Sorry.
All right, here we go. We do 29 of them. Go. Strudels. Door frame. Nakatomi Plaza. 29. All right, carry on with the stories.
Okay. So, when the religious leader asked what the greatest commandment was, he was trying to trap Jesus. If Jesus gave the wrong answer in front of all those people, he would look foolish.
Oh.
But Jesus actually had a great answer to the question. The greatest commandment, he said, was to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, love him with all your mind. This is the first and most important commandment.
Hold your habeas corpus! You know the exercise, head, shoulders, knees, and toesies?
I know the song.
This is not like that at all. This is called heart, soul, and mind. I put my hands on my heart, all right, before raising my leg to touch the soles of my feet. Then I drop my leg and I touch my head like I'm mind melding. We do 50-11s of them. Ready?
Wait, 50-11s?
Go!
Oh.
Heart, souls, minds, one. Heart, souls, minds, 47. Hearts, souls, minds, Judge Watner. Heart, souls, minds, Megaroon. Heart, souls, minds, 50-11s!
Well, that was...
Chicken break! Mm-hmm. Ooh, pump the protein. I don't know.
Well, you need those nutrients.
Second break over!
Okay, moving on. So, Jesus said the greatest commandment is to love God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. Mm. Loving God is the most important thing we can do. But Jesus wasn't finished with his answer. There was a little more to it. Jesus said, and the second is like it. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. Everything that is written in the law and the prophets is based on these two commandments.
Final exercise! It is a partner exercise.
Oh.
All right, and I call it neighbor, salt and shaker. You stand back to backs.
Oh.
And then you link arms. Yeah, like this. Yeah, yeah. And then one at a time you will lean overs, pulling your neighbor off their feet.
Got it.
We'll do the three of these.
Just three?
Three is the new 78. All right, here we go. One! Toes! Eggplant! Juice Newton! Hernia! I think I just gave my lumbar a lawsuit!
Oh, okay. Well, I'll finish up real quick.
Okay, I'll move over here. and yeah.
Love God and love others. That's our greatest responsibility. Jesus said everything was based on those two commandments.
That seems a whole lot easier than taking care of a pet.
Yeah, especially pet tigers.
It certainly is easy to remember, but sometimes loving others can be tough. But when we are followers of Jesus, we have the responsibility to love God and to love one another. Wow, are you okay?
Yeah, I just can't move my back for 3 months, but I can still exercise my eyebrows. I call this the caterpillar crunch. Ready? One, two,
cheese, floor.
I'm sure he will be better the next time he's on.
Now, nose flares!
Back to you.
You know, maybe we should rethink this whole pet thing and get something with a lot less expectations.
Ooh, like? Dwayne!
Yes, I thought we discussed this. Rock is a very boring pet.
Oh, yeah, but Dwayne's the most electrifying rock in show business!
Reveal the question!
What are things you're expected to do?
Well, growing up, I was always expected to tell the truth.
Oh, that's a good one. I was expected to make up my bed and brush my teeth.
Oh, man, that would have been a good one for me.
Which one? You know, don't answer. What are some things you are expected to do?
Yeah, it could be at school, could be at home, or could be at a rehearsal or a practice.
Yep. And with that, we'll see you next week for another brand new show.
See ya!
Along with Dwayne!